check out the architecture up here, guys. And it goes all the way around. I don't want to loosen it up any further, but yeah, you can see that they pretty much destroyed the marble. Oh, before I do go upstairs, let's check out the pattern on the heating element. Head upstairs. Here's some more benches right here. I don't want to move this. Here's the door is right here. But here is the library. Now, I'm not sure if this is a pattern of his sister or what. His likeness of his sister, but either way, it's some woman. Seems to be hardly used. Yeah, all of this wood is still in good condition. Alright, this is labeled room number 2. So this bedroom is overlooking Euclid Avenue. So you see 3 large windows. and some decay. Some hardwood floors. Check out the knobs here. And here we have the same heating elements throughout the whole house. Yeah, this is really unbelievable. This is the, would be the master bedroom right here. So this one has even bigger windows, as you would expect. And of course, another fireplace. But this room has even more signs of vandalism. I mean, scrappers came in and destroyed the place, or some of it. The owner told me that someone actually had broke in and was living in here. Which is really sad, but that's the MO around here. This fireplace isn't as nice as the ones downstairs, but it's decent. And you can see the bricks still have the WWCO written on them. So I don't know what that stands for. This is a nice size closet. Some screens in here. Yeah, really nice size closet. Not bad at all, not bad at all. Absolutely love this house. This room has this room number four. Well, before we go to room number four, here's a bathroom, another bathroom. And this is the other side of that wall where you see the vandalism. So the same heating elements. Let's see. Okay, that's nothing. All right. Now this room. This room is the room. Oh, it has the roof leak. So. Trying to remember the layout. out here. Okay, yeah. I remember now. Okay, this room is where they would keep, like, the bedding, the towels, sheets and stuff like that. Blankets. Oh, you can see the labels right here. Heavy blankets. Light blankets. I don't know what chip is. Towels. Bedding. And they would hang their coats up here. But yeah. And owner said she doesn't know who this guy is. And I don't know who the guy is either. So. Alright. Well, you can see this old wallpaper has a pattern of, I don't know if you can see this, if you can make it out, but it's a bird. It looks like a blue jay. But it's really old. Really old wallpaper. Okay, now you can see it. Alright, now there's a creepy part. Up this way. That. I want to show you guys. Alright, guys, now this is the area where I heard that noise. That was up here. There's some stuff in there that I missed the first time. I'm gonna go in there and poke around a little bit. But I'll head in there before I go back downstairs. But This one right here. Oh, check this out. This was left behind. But yeah, you guys have any idea why this would be on the door? It's like so weird. I never seen any doors like this inside of a house. Like, why would a door like this be inside of a house? It's a thick screen. The first time I was gonna open up this door, and then something said help. I didn't hear it like in real time. I only heard it like when I reviewed the footage. Either way, this is a room with a potty. And this too is overlooking Euclid Avenue. And you can see Popeyes right here. Elderwood is right down the way, so it's not too far. So we have some drawers that was built in to the wall, see? Nice and sturdy. And a bench overlooking the street. I believe the owner shared with me a story that the person that lived in the house had some cats, and this whole part right here, this area, they use for cat litter. Entire thing, and I'm not sure, but when they left the house, they left a few cats behind, and I ended up finding one that was left behind. Pieces of it was left behind. I mean, actually, you can see. I'm not sure if that's a piece of it right there, but. Oh yeah, here's some scattered bones right here. Some vertebrae down here in the corner. But yeah, I'm not sure if it was the squatters that had came in and left the cat or whatever. Well, either way, somebody left the cats. Left a couple of them, I think. Have another room, and now this baffles me right here. Clawfoot tub that was the vandals destroyed. I mean, they literally just destroyed the tub. Why? I don't know. How? I don't know. I mean, let me look at this. How in the world, or would you even take the time to destroy this tub? Crazy. Oh gosh. Leg of something. Let's Looks like a blood trail. Alright. Alright, now let's head to this little cubby hole before we go down to the basement. Now, here's this room. This looks like one of those lottery barrels. No, this is just a couple old magazines. Old Sweetheart Nancy. Anna Cole. Cleveland native Holly Berry. Jennifer Aniston and Britney Spears. And Madonna. Okay, this is another room, and oh, this is the oddball. The one heating element without the same pattern. Alright, let's head to this cubby hole. And before we go down to the basement now, I found something I usually find all the time. And if you view my videos, I'm sure you probably know what I found already. A Hammond organ. Now the owner didn't know that it was even left down in the basement because she never goes down there because of this. Of course, the story that she heard. She's never been in here and she's never been in the basement, so she had no clue that she had a Hammond organ in the basement, nor does she know what she has in here. So, let's take a look, guys. We have a typewriter, Underwood. I'm not sure if this is a good brand or not. Alright, so we have a Underwood typewriter. Does it say it on the case too? Yeah. So is this a good typewriter, guys? Underwood? Not sure. And here we have some old luggage with looks like a check mark on it. But I'm not sure if it's a V or a check mark. Let's see. It does have something written in the inside, so dusty here. Verdi. It says Verdi here on the inside. So mattress. And this looks like some kind of a pump we have here. Some kind of a tank. Tank, piece of toilet. It's an old Apple monitor we have here. And it looks like that's it. Pretty much. Old VHS player. And what is this? Is this one of those projector things? Projector, I don't know. Not sure. And some more cases of luggage cases. So nothing too much. Nothing spectacular. Alright, so let's go down to the basement, guys. Oh, what's this? Some Christmas stuff. Decorations. Alright, what do you say we head down to the basement? Now the owner never came down here. Like, she literally doesn't know what's down here. And I'm not sure either. I mean, I did see that organ the first time, so I decided to come back and do some more poking around. And I was hoping there was going to be a record player in here, but I don't see anything. And I can't really, I don't see any handle. Oh, here it is. Let me try to open it with this one. It's like maybe shut too tight. I can't get in here, but it does look like used to be a record player, so it might be on this side and not on this side. I'm not sure, but you guys see the name. I'm done counting on how many of these I find. I've done found. And looks like everything's still inside, so. And I wanted to check some of this stuff out too, so I don't know. This one doesn't look like it's worth anything, but I'm not sure about this baby. These look like molds to something. Can't really tell to what. And another lamp. Dart machine, dartboard, and some drawers. And there's a little room here. Got some meters too. Check that out. Yeah, they're so dirty and dusty, you can't even see UD, huh? Yeah, there's really nothing to see here. So this house, this might be a candidate for, overnight challenge. What do you say, guys? I think it might be. So, I don't know. You guys let me know if I should do an overnight challenge here or not. If I get enough requests, I might do one here.